Hi there, welcome back. So let's look at how can we construct a logic circuit from a given problem statement. So first of all, let's look at the problem statement. So this is the problem statement. Construct a logic circuit based on x equal to 1 if a equal to 1 or b equal to 1 or a equal to 0 and b equal to 1. So this is the given problem statement. So the first thing that we'll do is just convert this into an equation. So what will be the given equation then? So this will be the equation. It's equal to bracket a plus b bracket plus bracket a inverse dot b bracket. So definitely if this is your first time looking at this equation, it might look a bit complicated. But just let me slowly go through on this equation itself. So first of all, x equal to 1. So it means that this whole equation is actually designed for x equal to 1. So for a equal to 1, I'm just going to write a here. And or will be just plus here, so a plus and b equal to 1, I'm just going to write b here, and then I'm just going to close the bracket here. And then since this is the or statement, I'm just going to write a plus here. And since this is a equal to 0, it means that I'll be putting a inverse here. And then this is the n is just going to be a dot here. And then b equal to 1, I'm just going to write a b here. And now I just close the bracket here. So in conclusion, x equal to 1, if a equal to 1 or b equal to 1, so a plus b here, and then or plus here, a equal to 0, a inverse, n dot, and b equal to 1, just b here, and close the bracket. So this is the equation based on the given statement. So after writing down the equation, the next thing I'm going to do is to draw the circuit. So let me just draw the circuit on my tablet here. So first of all, when I draw the circuit, I'm just going to write the equation on the top as I draw the circuit. So let me just write out the equation first. So a plus b plus a inverse dot b, and then bracket. So if I look at this equation here, since we have a and a inverse here, I'm just going to write b first and then write a as an input. So I'm just going to draw like that. It's going to be b, and then this is going to be a. The reason why I put a below b because a will be inverse. I will need to inverse the a later. Therefore, I'm just going to put a below b here. So I'm just going to start with drawing this first equation here, which is this one here. So a plus b. So I'm just going to draw an OR gate here. So hopefully you still remember how to draw the OR gate. So this is how you draw the OR gate. Okay, so we are done forming this first equation. And next thing that I'm going to do is I'm just going to start with this a inverse dot b here. And because you know that this a has to be inverse, I will need to inverse this a input as an inverse a. So what I'm going to do here is I'm just going to draw like that. Just going to draw it down here. And then I'm just going to add a NOT gate here. So this is the NOT gate here. So using this bottom line here, I will be able to form A inverse, which is this here. So the output will be somewhere, this will be A inverse here. So the output at the bottom here will be A inverse. And then I'm just going to draw a B from here. So this is going to be B, I'm just going to come to here. And the next thing I'm going to do is that I'm just going to draw this A inverse dot B here into the bottom here. So what I'm going to do here is that I'm just going to draw the AND gate here. So this is the AND gate here. Okay, and then finally I'll be just combining these two equations together, which is this plus here. So I know that this is going to be an OR gate. So I'm just going to draw an OR gate here first. And then I'm just going to put this as output X, so since they use X. And then finally I will just join all the line together. So I'm just going to join all the line together now. So, and yeah. Here you go. So basically, this is how I construct a logic circuit from a problem statement. So let's go back to the slide first. So this is how the circuit looks like as I drew on my iPad itself. So this is how it looks like. So let's just do a quick run through again. So we have A here and B here. So A plus B, this bracket here stands for this OR gate here. And I'm just going to inverse this using a NOT gate here. So A will come to this NOT gate here, forming A inverse here, and then B will just come to here and then go to an AND gate here, since this is A dot B, so this is an AND gate. And finally, I will just join both of the input together to an OR gate, which is this X here. So just join all the line together here. And yeah, that's it. So as usual, if you enjoy my tutorial, definitely just like my video and subscribe to the channel. And if you are taking A-level computer science, definitely check out my upcoming online course at www.haguin.school. Thank you, and I'll see you again then. Bye-bye.